Discord. Now, Discord is an interesting beast when I think about it, because for the longest time that I've been gaming on PC, I've mostly used Skype. That was how people on PC communicated with each other. It was kind of like our party chat system. You would download Skype and all of that. But the problem with Skype was it wasn't really focused around gaming. I think Skype actually used up a lot of CPU. It used up a lot of your PC's resources or something like that. But then came along Discord, and at first, not very many people made the switch to Discord, but now, whenever I'm gaming on PC, all my friends are on Discord. We hardly ever use Skype anymore. And so Discord has really blown up recently in terms of PC gaming. And now Discord is setting their sights on Steam. They're adding free games, and they're launching their own online store to compete with Steam, which I think is a good thing, but let's go through this a little bit. So basically, the beta for game sales rolls out in Canada on Thursday to 50,000 randomly selected customers. Those selected will see an upgraded version of Discord Nitro that has access to a curated selection of games along with the current subscription perks. They'll also see a new tab in the home screen, the Discord store, with individual games for purchase. Initially, only Windows PC users will be supported for the program. They're also not sure how long the beta test will last in Canada, but they plan to slowly roll the new storefront out over time and make decisions based on user feedback. And it says here that we hope to slowly expand the beta to test different markets' currencies prior to full launch later this year. Now, fortunately, Discord isn't getting insane. They're a little bit realistic. And right here, he says, let me put it this way. If we could build a fraction of what Steam has built, we would be very proud. And to be honest, at least they're down to earth on that one, because Steam is just ginormous. They arguably almost have a monopoly on the digital distribution of PC games. Like, Steam is just huge. That's a bit of a hyperbolic statement, but you get what I mean. When people game on PC, it's all about Steam. So I think it's a good thing that, because I do think that Discord can possibly go for them somewhat. I have no idea how this is going to go, but it sounds like they're going to implement some kind of a monthly subscription thing where you get free games or something like that. I don't know if you can only play the free game for a month, but basically it's kind of like Xbox Live and PlayStation Plus, where you get a free game or a few free games every month, and then you can download them and play them for as long as you have Xbox Live Gold or PlayStation Plus. But this will just obviously just be Discord Nitro, and you know, it'll be optional, and they'll have a more traditional store, much like the Steam store. But I do think it's good that there's another gaming giant out there going after Steam, because even though Steam has a pretty okay track record so far, I don't want to see them become apathetic to user feedback or just complacent and they just don't give a shit about consumers. Because that's what happens. When a company starts dominating the market, they reach a point where they start to become arrogant and they don't really listen to the consumer anymore. They're kind of like, oh yeah, well, we're this company and we can get away with anything. You basically just have to suck it up. Until another company comes by and fucking slams them on the floor and puts them back into their place. I think Discord, assuming that they do things properly and assuming that they grow slowly and assuming that they slowly get a bigger footprint in this market, I do think that they can compete with Steam, and they might be the checks and balances that we need in this little scene where Steam doesn't become arrogant and Discord is constantly innovating, and we'll just see kind of a back and forth thing between them, kind of like with Sony and Microsoft, although, you know, they kind of trade places with arrogance there. I mean, PS4 has been having problems with the cross-platform play and all of that, and recently Sony's been kind of arrogant with, oh, we'll just suck it up, and they've basically, I don't know, but that's a different topic for a different video. But basically, I do want to see Discord succeed in this, and I'm curious what kind of stuff is going to come out on Discord. Are they going to have Discord exclusive games? That would actually be very interesting. Is Discord Nitro going to turn into a subscription, or I mean, it already is a subscription-based thing, but is it going to turn into something like Xbox Live Gold or PS Plus, where you get a free game every month or something, and maybe you can continue playing it as long as if you have Discord Nitro, or, you know, maybe it's like a little trial thing. I feel like people would still pay for that as long as if it was cheap, but It says here that they will still focus on text and voice chat. That is Discord's number one focus still. So I think that's great. Okay, if Discord keeps that as their main focus, because that's what people use them for, then I don't see why this is a terrible endeavor. I see this as a good endeavor, and some good things might come out of it. They might be able to, like I said, they might be the checks and balances to make sure that Steam doesn't become too arrogant. I mean, I've heard horror stories about Steam's customer service, so maybe if Discord actually starts to take off, maybe Steam will actually start to give a shit about their customer service. But I don't know. This is all speculation. I hope you agree with my speculation, and be sure to rate, comment, favorite, and subscribe, and I'll be sure to see you in my next video.